All right, in studio right now, a couple of the guys that I say are two of the more talented guys around the old country music scene. Everybody say hi to Brothers Osborne.
Yeah. Hello,
Brothers Osborne.
What's up, y'all?
How are you guys?
I'm feeling pretty good, actually.
It's been a minute since we've seen you guys, and so I kind of like to start by giving the audience a little taste of what they've been missing. If you wouldn't mind, break me off a little piece of rum before we talk, because I got some stuff to talk about. Yeah, let's do a little rum.
All right, here we go. Never too early for rum. Here we go.
Brothers Osborne in the studio right now. Obviously, by their tuning, they weren't ready for me to go right to rum.
You never know what to expect. I like that about you. All right, we just want to jump into a chorus here.
Let's do verse chorus.
Okay. Staring at the prettiest part of this powder keg world. Sitting with the finest example of a beautiful girl. If we hadn't hit the brakes, we'd have no idea paradise was hiding right here. Dipping our toes in the water, I don't care if it gets any hotter. It's you and me remembering how to have fun. Put our hearts together. Two parts love and a pinch of good weather. And top it all off with the sun. And mix it with rum.
Nice job. That's it right there. Good. That's a good start to the interview. Hey, be for real with me for a second. Because you guys are kind of no nonsense. You guys know I'm a legitimate fan. Do you know that?
And you know what? Actually, I do know that, and I really appreciate that about you. Not only not only about us, but you get a couple new artists, and you jump on them early, and that's awesome. You know, Cam, that we've just recently become friends with, she's awesome.
Dude, she sing like
awesome.
A magical song?
Like a dove.
Yeah, yeah.
Like an angel.
Yeah, we played a show with her recently, and I'd never heard her before, and I heard the hype, and then I saw her, and I was like, I totally understand why there's hype around this girl. She's totally awesome, cool songs.
And legit, like the real thing, you know? Yeah. She's
it's like you guys. Sweetheart. It's like the real thing. I just want you guys to know I'm a legit fan.
Thanks, Bobby. I really am.
A lot of DJs are full of crap, and I am too, but just not with artists. Like, I won't have an artist and be like, I'm a fan.
They
if
just
I'm
just
really
say that
not
to
a fan.
That walks in.
Yeah.
Like, you guys are legit. I stood in the front in 105 degree weather in Dallas and watched you guys.
Oh, thanks, dude.
Sweating my brains off.
It was brutal.
That's what I'm talking about. So, Brothers Osborne are here with us. I got to ask you, because I say the same thing and I get called out a lot for it. And it's what I would call for a while, like wallet chain radio. That's what I was calling it. And you guys are all over the headlines.
Like
enough BS. Like, what's substance? Like, I want to know what you meant by that.
I think it's not necessarily like substance or really any of that. I think it's mostly just honesty. You know, like, no matter who you are, just really be yourself and don't chase a trend. Because I feel like within everybody, within all of us in this room, and every artist in Nashville and outside of Nashville, there's a fire that you have. And it burns, and it's very pure. But the thing is, when you start chasing the dollar and all that stuff, it becomes less pure, you know? And I feel like it kind of started to do that for a minute because certain things were becoming more popular and people were changing themselves.
Of course, everybody was changing to be all, let's tap a keg and wear wallet chains.
Exactly.
So when you guys said that, I was like, I like that about those guys. They're going to get some flack. But I get flack too for
we
saying
we surprisingly
the same.
Didn't get that much flack because I feel like a lot of people felt the same way.
But they won't all say it.
Exactly. No. Well, no one's really saying it. And we kind of found that when we did say it, we don't really know anything else other than just speak from the heart, you know. But people were like, thank you for saying that. A lot of country fans feel the same way. I mean, we're real, real country fans. I mean, I grew up on this stuff and love the stuff, the old stuff. And so I really care about where it's going and where it is now.
Brothers Osborne are here. We're going to play the new single in a second. But what I want to hear first, if I were to say, throw a little cover at me, give me something old school. What would you guys do if I said, throw a little old school cover at me?
Old school. We got that.
Old school? Well, we like to play this one live. You know, we don't do a ton of cover songs. But when we do, we usually like to make it old school. So here's one that you all probably know. And Bobby, you can sing along.
I will not sing along. I will not ruin the masterpiece. Brothers Osborne. Here we go.
All right.
One, two, one, two, three.
Yeah, hey, good looking. Whoa. you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Yeah, hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we can find us a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a spot right over the hill. There's soda pop and a dancing spree, so if you wanna have fun, come along with me. Say, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Take it away, here we go. Find me 1, 4, 5, or 10 cents. I'm keeping it till it's covered with age, cause I'm writing your name down on every page. Hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Yeah, how's about cooking something up with me?
Oh my goodness, how about that? Man,
that's
let me
solo.
Tell you about that. I mean, that's old school. That's what I like about old school. My grandma and I would listen to that Hank record. Like, that's Hank Sr.
Yeah,
too.
Hank Sr. Oh, yeah.
We would listen, because she had a record player, and it was Ray Charles and Hank Sr., and it was Andy Griffith, oddly, because you know, Andy Griffith was a Christian singer.
Yeah.
We would listen to that Hank record all the time. Like, when you played it, it like brought chills. I mean, that was awesome. I love that, man.
You know, I love like that old stuff like that, man. You can seriously play it anytime, anywhere. Anybody gets into that stuff. And that really is just like, I think, what makes country music so great. When it's real, everyone loves it.
Yeah. So who do you guys like right now? Like, do you hear and you go, dang, that's good.
What, out right now?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I mean, like we said, Cam, you know, the stuff that Little Big Town's putting out is just ridiculous. Like, everything that comes out. Eric, obviously. Dirks is always on fire. You know, and these are like genuinely like real people. They're just like doing their thing, you know.
Yeah.
We love Cadillac Three Boys, man. We gotta throw some love to them and Thousand Horses, who are like some of our best friends on the planet, you know. And
yeah, we're about to do a fall tour with John Party going into the fall, and we're a big fan of his, and he's crazy as hell. We love it.
Dude, that's just
it.
Wild, dude.
He is wild,
he's
man.
Nuts, man.
We may not make it out the other side of fall, but we'll see.
Brothers Osborne here in the studio with us. Gonna play the single in just a second. If I were to ask, because my favorite song is Love the Lonely Out of You.
Oh, man.
That's my favorite. Could you break off a little verse chorus of that?
Maybe.
I mean, I know it's early. I know it's early in the morning. And that's like the jam. That's like the, let me tell you, that to me, and you know, probably too slow to be a radio song, but man, when I sit at home alone in the closet and cry, that's my jam. All right, Brothers Osborne here. It's just a concert. They're so good. It's called Love the Lonely Out of You.
I can tell that you're lonely, so pour it all out on me, 'cause I've been lonely too. That's a heartache you're drinking, and I can feel what you're thinking. Let's do what the lonely do. Your lips, your shoulders, and my fingertips are running through your hair just like this. Whatever it takes to make your heart forget, I'll do. Oh, baby, let me love the lonely out of you.
Man, that's so good right there. You guys, the fan base is growing exponentially right now. Like, we can talk and be like, blah, 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 but I want people to hear how good you guys
just
are.
Saying.
Thanks, man.
Holy cow. Yeah, I mean, not in a bad way.
Yeah, not in a bad way.
But it's like, I like to showcase you guys.
Like,
shut up and sing.
I feel like you don't get showcased enough. Like, mm-hmm. I want people to hear this.
Okay. Thank you, man.
I want to play the single right now. So set it up for me. Tell me about this song.
Well, we wrote this song with a great friend of ours, a great writer in town named Shane McAnally, and he's had a lot of success lately. But we went into the write and we realized there's a lot of songs in country music that talk about falling in love and talking about having your heart broken, and we've certainly written a lot of those. And we're like, man, we want a song that kind of talks about that in-between thing where you're not really sure if you're in love or what you want to call it. You kind of tell yourself you're not in love, but then you find yourself, you know,
not wanting to be alone,
and you're picking up the phone and making the phone call. You're not sure if it's right, but, you know, next thing, the sparks are flying, and it's feeling right, and then you're alone again and wishing they could stay a little longer.
Yeah, something like a strong wind is coming over me. It's got a hold of me, yeah. Thinking and doing things I shouldn't be, I really shouldn't be. Yeah, but one more call is the one more what you doing right now. One trip to my side of town and you walk right in. It's one more, here we go again. One more drink leads to another. You slide up close to me. Tape your t-shirts on each other. Your hands all over me. I tell myself I'm not in love, but one more time is a not in love. One last kiss and then you're a goner. Like you should need to stay a little longer. Then you're gone, and I'm like, you wishing you could stay a little longer.